news. The head-to-head matchups have Saxton and Shaw 3-1 in the series. Before then, Saxon Shah beat them in Moscow 2015-2014 on two occasions, but their most recent meeting at the Summer Olympic Games saw the Dutch duo come out on top. Here we go with set number one. Canada must get into this match early, come out strong and dynamic against the Dutch Olympic bronze medalist. And it is Canada that put the first point on the board.
This team of Brouwer and Newsom, they're always a dangerous team. They won the World Championships in 2013. Then they won the Pritch Major in 2015. I call them big game hunters. You just never know when they're going to have a big pop. That's why a lot of people thought that they were in a great position to medal in Rio, and that's exactly what they did, bringing home the bronze medal for the Netherlands. So a team that is up and down at times, but a very powerful, dynamic team that's always playing aggressive volleyball.
Yeah, they like to hit the ball hard, there's no question of a doubt. And you can spot them. Moosen is the tallest player on the court, 6'9" or 2'7". His teammate Alex Brouwer, who wears the number one in the traditional orange shirts, called him Boom Boom Brouwer. He likes to pound that ball as hard as he can. But both players are settling in, Canada with the early advantage. Lucent serves, cross court to Saxton. Schalk with the set, Saxton on the attack. Good block at the net, this time from Brouwer.
It's interesting having Brouwer up at the net, and Musin, who is 6'9", playing defense. So a lot of different switches going on with different teams. Earlier we saw Laura Ludwig, who's the full-time defender. She was at the net at times, and a lot of teams giving different looks to the opposition on the other side. A lot of these taller players are becoming more interchangeable, can play defense, have the agility to do so.
As you explained to earlier, Danielson, it makes it even more difficult for the opposition to read the tactical play. Scores all tied at 3-0. Service errors from both the Canadian and the Dutch teams at this point. Here is Alex Brouwer, 26 years of age, from The Hague. How about that for an ace serve? No, the ball was just a little too long.
Serve goes long, we'll have our first side switch.
Close. Very fast serve.
Really close, and of course the challenge rule is in effect. Hawkeye system, monitoring all the lines, all the angles. If you don't agree with the call, you have an opportunity to challenge.
Oh, how about Saxton right there, up and over the net, nowhere to go for Brouwer. Some boosts to Ben Saxton's confidence. Canada in front of their own crowd to seek sweet revenge, and so far so good for Schalk and Saxton. Game Schalk putting a nice shot away there to give Canada a 3-point lead, 6-2-3.
Another beautiful stuff line by Saxton. That time the Netherlands able to keep the play. Canada winning the point nonetheless.
Another beautiful dig in the backcourt.
Came Schalk trying to go over on one, and that's always a risky play, or shall I say two, because it came off that block, and he errs just out of bounds. The court was completely open.
The tall man moves them with service.
All the work.
Well, that's good play from Canada. And they want to show these Dutch Olympic bronze medalists that they've got a power play part of their game as well. Here's his partner, Ben Saxton, from Toronto, Ontario. That's the second time Wilson's just not yet got his eye on the ball at the net.
Remember, there is a lot of moisture. The humidity is very high, so you have to focus on that contact, your hand on the ball. If you blink for just a second, that ball can drop and you can misjudge it. We've seen that a couple of times with Musin.
He just gets a touch on the ball, Saxton. That's the way they like to play, the Dutch lads. And he really does like hitting that ball hard, Alex Brown. And once he finds his form and rhythm, he's a difficult player to stop.
Yeah, because he's coming at you every time. If you don't have the perfect block to stop him or the perfect defensive position, then he's going to win the point. That's just the way he plays. Roll the dice. He doesn't care if you block him. He's going to come back and he's going to hit twice as hard the next time. So he almost challenges him. It's a strong strength for him, but it's also a weakness.
It's true. You can intimidate the other opposite teams as well with that style of play, and Panda mustn't get drawn into a kind of scrap, as they call it in boxing terminology. They just need to keep their rhythm and play their game. Get sucked in by the Dutch Bronswick. Nice little touch on the ball there. Good to see Brouwer mixing it up a little.
Don't see that often. Canada to a fantastic start. To a great start here, 9-6. They're playing consistent. That's the big key for the Canadians. Can they play consistent volleyball and squeaking it through the 6-9 music? Is that Brouwer?
It's Brouwer at the net again.
They start confusing.
Yeah. So she puts the right tactic, makes them happy with themselves. And Saxon serves for Canada, the white and red. Oh, great play by Saxton. Read that block perfectly. Timing, sweet.
Saxton has been spectacular here early on. His timing, perfect. Look at him hang in the air, throw that one back onto the Netherlands side of the net. Two blocks already.
Saxton too deep and long. Too much power on the ball on that service. Point advantage, Canada. Brouwer is for his run in and power shot.
That's his runway back there. He uses maximum distance to do so. And it's interesting watching different players. Some have a short approach. He definitely has a long approach.
Been on that point in service. That is another error, this time from Sharp.
He just tried to get a little touch off the block.
There's that consistency. Nice lead by Canada, and then all of a sudden, they give up 3 points in a row. Netherlands coming at them strong.
Great shot. Good shot, important point score for Canada going into the technical timeout. 12-9. Stopping that very quick run of points from the Dutch. Canada maintain the 3-point lead at the halfway point in set one. Just the 3-point advantage opening up his first set. Sharp and ready to go from the first play. But Dutch now starting to find their rhythm. They look at bronze medalists from Holland. And they look towards the end. First half of set one. Important that Canada keep their momentum and focus here. That's the classic play from Holland with their moves and now adopting the blocker's role. Tallest man on court. than it is with service. Way too big. Long.
He likes to do that jump forward serve. I'd like to see him at 6'9" really rip a traditional topspin serve because he is so tall, and we see how effective it can be with a taller player like Evandro from Brazil, who is last year's best server. Not too close, not too far off. Wow, what a set.
Service error from Brown.
17-13.
Kim Chunk.
Brower didn't blast that one. He played the smart play. And I've talked to him about that. He just says he loves to hit the ball. He knows that it probably would make his game a little better if he would throw out some finesse here and there, but it's just not his game. He might see a challenge out of this one. Really close. So Brower points to the ref, and the ref's
Yeah! Come on, 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 come on Thank you. Yeah! Thank you.